of Christ, he came for the purpose of destroying every work of the enemy in your life. And I declare today that if you hear this word today and believe it, we are taking off every ceiling above your head, and God will be your limit. The sky will never be your limit. The devil brings people strategically to chop off your confidence. They close doors of potential by convincing you that you are nothing. But Jesus tells you that you are not a nothing. You are somebody if you believe in this word. They tell you, you will never rise above your family status. I don't care. Your father was a teacher. You will become more than a teacher. Like Jeremiah, his father was just a priest. But God ordained Jeremiah to become a prophet to many nations. God can do it in your life if you believe this word. These people will tell you, you will never go beyond your neighborhood. You will never go beyond where your neighborhood took you. You are a ghetto boy, you remain a ghetto boy. The devil is a liar, and his lies, we are exposing them today. We have many people who believed in God, who were raised in ghetto, but have become prominent figures in their communities. Not only prominent, but become fathers of communities. And you are also destined for greatness. You were created and wired for greatness in the mighty name of Jesus. They will tell you, you will never be more than your mama, more than your daddy. Your daddy was a teacher. They say you will never drive. They say you will never own a house in an urban area. Who told you that you can never get this? The Bible says, whose report do you believe? I'm standing here in the place of God, delivering the mind of God into your life, that all things are possible if you believe this word. They may say you don't stand a chance. Remember, you and God, you are a majority. The devil has been preaching and teaching all these lies just to keep us down, but I refuse to be down. I am not down, but I'm above everything in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, irrespective and irregardless of what people are saying, it is written that, but for this purpose, Jesus came. When it says for this purpose, what it means is, it has been decided in heaven between the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost that Jesus must come here to destroy the works of Satan, to destroy the lies of the devil. He came to free us from those things that retard, that delay, that hold you back. He came to free us from the things that distort, that twist you out of shape. He came to destroy every short circuit in your life, that you may realize the maximum potential of your life. You are capable of attaining anything that you think about. The Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. Whatever you can think, whatever you can imagine, you are bound to receive it in the name of Jesus. So John chapter 10 verse 10, it says, I am come that they may have life and have it more abundantly. The reason why Christ came, the church was more like a valley that was filled with dry bones, rather than being a pasture filled with the grazing flock. It was a valley of dry bones. So many churches, people, they gather. It's either it's a lively church because the Spirit of Christ is reigning in that church, or it is a valley of dry bones. People who are gathering, but they don't experience an encounter with the Almighty God, the owner of the church. Remember Matthew 16, Jesus said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Some people are building their own churches, but Christ has his own church, not denominations. We are talking of the universal church of God. What is a dry bone church? It's a church where politics is preached on the pulpits. A dry bone church where bitterness is spread instead of healing of souls. Jostling for positions. conversing for places of honor, campaigning and de-campaigning one another. That's typically a dry-bone church. There is bitterness, there is jealousy, there is haters in that church. Sin is rampant. Religion is about rituals. It's not about an experience with the Spirit of the living God. They preach self-righteousness other than the righteousness of God. Everybody whom they look, who is not their clique, is unrighteous except themselves. These are the Pharisees of today. Remember in Revelation chapter 3, verse 1 to 6, Jesus talked about a dead church, the church that was in Sardis. There are elements and there are characteristics of a dead church. You need to take an inventory and examine where you belong. Is it a dead church? Or it's a church that I experience the life of God. If there is no fire, I encourage you today, leave that church, find a church that preaches the living word of Jesus Christ. The one that said, I will build my church. Find the church of Jesus Christ, not a church that has dehumanized, placing men on top and Christ has been demoted. Find that church. Christ says, I have come that they may have life and have it in abundance. The word abundance means fountain. And fountain speaks of a well that we want to re-dig today and bring out the treasure that has been hidden in that well. Jesus' purpose to come to this earth was to remove that cap and to open that well so that we enjoy the wealth that has been closed by the devil. In other words, he came to unclog the true you, to open the capacity of who you are and who you can be in the name of Jesus. What you are today is not what you are supposed to be tomorrow. You are supposed to grow in dimensions and grow in all levels in the name of Jesus. I prophesy, after hearing this message, there's going to be an oil spill. There's going to be an explosion of the abundance of God's blessing in your life. I want you to believe it. It's not your environment that will bring blessing to you. You can change that environment in the mighty name of Jesus. So Jesus says he didn't come just to take off the cape over your well, but he also came for an explosion, to start an explosion. Remember in John chapter 3 verse 38, he says, whosoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, streams of living water will flow from within him. Also in John chapter 4 verse 14, he says, whosoever drinks the water I give him will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life. So his main purpose, Christ, was to remove the cap, to destroy the works of the devil. He came to destroy the devil's scheme over your life and allow the power and the Spirit of God to do the destruction of the devil's work. He came to unclog and to show you your true self. What does that mean? Remember the woman that Jesus met at the well, John chapter 4. Many people knew her as a harlot. They knew her as a prostitute because she was in the business of hiring and firing men into her life. But when Christ had an encounter with that woman, she never became a harlot because he came to reveal the true nature of that woman. She became the evangelist to the community of Samaria. That's her true nature. So what people call you is not what you are today. He has the power to change you today in the name of Jesus. They say you are poor, but the Bible says through his poverty we were made rich. They say you are sick, but the Bible says by his stripes we are healed. Your true nature is to reveal the nature of God in your life in the name of Jesus. Why did Christ come in this world? Why was he manifested? Why did he incarnate as a son of God in this world? He came to vindicate divine truth because the devil has been parading his lies, has been propagating false doctrines. He came to purify divine ordinances. He came to correct men's errors. Men are full of errors. Don't depend upon men. Depend upon God. Because men are bound to make errors. He came to renew their hearts. He also came to reform our lives. He came to redress our grievances. He came to sanctify and support us under our trials and troubles. He came to seek that which was lost. He came to bind up that which was broken. He also came to strengthen that which was weak. And this to his church was life from the dead. We were actually resurrected by the coming of Christ. He is the best destroyer that I know. The devil is a destroyer, but Jesus came to destroy the works of the enemy. John says, Jesus came into this world to destroy the works of the devil. The work of the devil, remember, is to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus came to tear off every cap and to open up every well. Revelation 3 verse 7, it says, he who opens and no one shuts, and he who shuts and no one opens. What does it mean to destroy the works of the devil? You may be asking from wherever you are, what does it mean when you say he came to destroy the works of the devil? He came to reverse whatever Satan has done in your life, in the mighty name of Jesus. He came to change your background. He came to undo what was done by the devil in your life. Remember the woman at the well. She was labeled as a harlot, yet she was an evangelist. You must find your true purpose. Jesus came to reverse what was done by the devil in your life. Remember Peter's mother-in-law. She was sick, couldn't do anything because she had fever. But when Christ healed her, she became industrious, doing what she couldn't do. That's the purpose of Christ being revealed in this world. Legion, the man who had many demons upon him, remember when he was delivered, the Bible says he went to the 10 cities preaching the word of God. Yet the devil had killed and destroyed the potential of this man, but Jesus came to reverse whatever the devil had done. The man at the beautiful gate, Acts chapter 3, he was seated there receiving alms, receiving handouts from people. A man who was supposed to fend for his family. A man who was supposed to make a contribution to his community. A man who was supposed to make a significant contribution even to his nation. But he was crippled by the enemy so that he became an invalid. Whatever the devil did to him, Christ came to reverse what was done by the devil. And I declare in your life, whatever you failed to do in all these years, I'm declaring it today. Go and do it in the name of Jesus. Not by might, nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. The devil is on the business of filling every well with debt. Remember when he fed the 5,000 with bread. It also means he had put people into a condition of poverty. That's the devil. And Christ came to change that condition in Jesus' mighty name. Whenever he opened up blind eyes, it was the devil's business to close every eye. So Christ is a destroyer of what was done by the devil. And also the devil is a destroyer of what God did in the Garden of Eden when he blessed man in Jesus' mighty name. Satan akabata chivharo chekuvharisa zvakaitwa naMwari, but Jesu ane mugwara waakauya nawo, a crowbar to open up every lid that was put by the devil. That's why the devil always says to you, you are not saved. But when Christ came, he said, you are saved, and his name is the Savior. Satan akaisa chivharo, and he said, you always feel that pain. But Jesus, when he came, he said, you are healed in my name. Satan will always tell you,